hardest part about writing your story for the first time will not be figuring out how it sounds, but realizing that no one else has ever said it before. That every wall our back been pushed against, every ceiling we prove wrong, will never prepare us for the moment that we are given the floor. See, in my travels, I've seen some stories stuck pacing empty school hallways or cuffed to the back seat of a squad car. I've seen some collect dust in the ear that no one speaks about or rust behind a toilet of some grungy rock bar. So maybe your story is much more like mine. More roach-infested basement than Roman Empire, more red and blue flashing lights than youth retreat campfires. So when you tell me that you can't write poetry because your soul is just tired of speaking, your heart is just tired of leaking, your tongue can give two shits about saving anyone, when your throat has spent the last decade healing, well, believe me when I say that I get it. We both know that people on the posters we plastered on the inside of our lockers made it look way too easy. But this, right here, this is white knuckle narrative. The kind of story that only sounds good when you're scared of it. This has nothing to do with paradise. It is paying homage to the trees we chose to sacrifice. But this has always had way more to do about bravery. Less about talent. Back when I spent 27 years in this hellhole, and so I'm down for a challenge. Because to be honest, it is just you and this scalpel, no one else. And poetry is just another steady hand performing soul surgery on yourself. And all these people are going to tell you about the beauty on the inside. It's a thing. It's a thing. But this is showing how ugly it looks when you try to find it. And then when you are knee deep in the dirt that you have dug from your rug, this is how you choose to keep your voices inside quiet. See, when excavating your first story, some nights will feel more jackhammer than Indiana Jones. You're gonna dig until you don't feel the difference between gold and bone. And you'll find that the first few times always tastes like blood on the way up. But if the alternative is keeping your mouth shut, well, hey, gotta tell it. Because believe me, it's possible. When the tip or if your shovel hits, the reason why you exist, you will feel unstoppable. I've seen a single father pay his daughter's tuition with a poem. I've seen a young teen rewrite his addiction with a poem. I've seen a young teen rewrite his own conviction with a poem. I've seen a room full of students stop and listen to a poem. Homie, I know what it feels like to have all your demons conspire against you. To feel like your story isn't worth telling. To have a room full of uniforms pretending that they can't hear your heart in the midst of all this yelling. But that's the point. That the burning existence you crack open cannot avoid its tendency to inspire. In this plot, you are both the swordsman and the blacksmith, and both learn how to conquer and control fire. The story is yours. Don't dull its greatness with doubt. It is when anthills feel like mountains and this tunnel seems to go on forever, when someone else's story has shown me a way out. We've been tricked, right? And in believing that perfectly packaged products are in mass appeal, this world has been dying to hear something real. All I've been doing is copying and pasting. Give me something I can't steal. All we've been doing is hearing the bullshit. Give me something I can feel. And on the days when breathing feels more like the end than character development, we'll screw it. We'll make do on this stage. Maybe life has been throwing a lot more tomatoes than lemons these days. We'll screw it. We'll make juice either way. And like puddles of rain, collecting the footsteps we'll be behind in this desert, our stories can still save someone's life. Like the few seconds before the death of a star, this is just pain. Made to look a lot like light. Thank you.